Hi guys, I wanted to talk to you about my signature stick made by Vic Firth. A lot of guys ask me what kind of sticks I'm using. I'm using my own signature model, and I'm very lucky and very honored to be a signature artist with Vic Firth sticks. I never thought that would happen to me. I'm living proof that dreams can come true. About 15 years ago, I was living in Germany and playing a lot of metal, and I was looking for a stick that would kind of serve the purposes of my playing. Now I'm known for playing heavy, but as the years progressed, I wanted to play with more finesse and have a little bit more articulation on the cymbals and play thinner drum heads. So this takes me back to my journey, because years ago when I was much younger, I thought thicker sticks were better, heavier was louder, bigger drums were louder, more powerful, and actually it's quite the opposite. And this started to become clear to me when I was going to see some drum clinics. Some of my favorite drummers, Simon Phillips, who was a god for all of us drummers, and Steve Smith as well. It was after a Simon Phillips clinic that I had the opportunity to not really play Simon's drums, but I had the opportunity to go behind the drums and just hit each tom. And the sound and the tone, the note that came back, the resonant note, was just amazing. A lot of that is due to the fact that Simon is very meticulous. He's an expert tuner. But the other part of it is that he's using very thin resonant drum heads on top and bottom. I think it's Remo. He's using Remo Clear Ambassadors on the top and the bottom. So by tuning those two heads, you get a very beautiful resonant tone. Another clinic that I was playing, I had the opportunity to play before Steve Smith in somewhere up in Northern California near San Francisco. I guess I was a bit nervous about that because I'm a big fan of Steve Smith. And when I had played with Tony McAlpine, I really loved that first record that Steve Smith played on called Edge of Insanity. Steve Smith on drums, of course, Tony McAlpine on guitar and keyboards, and Billy Sheehan on bass. It's an awesome rock and fusion record. And so I was very influenced by that sound. I remember the toms on that record had a very open, airy tuning, and very musical, very melodic. So Steve had set up his drums and finished his sound check and went to the hotel. I finished setting up my drums, which I was using very large drums and very heavy sticks at the time. I just kind of went behind his drums and tapped on the drums and the cymbals, and I noticed that the drum heads were very thin. And I also noticed that the cymbals were very thin. And I thought, this must be part of his secret. You know, because I was using very heavy cymbals and very large drums and very heavy sticks with no tip, just the butt end of the stick. I'll show you a picture of that later. Something just kind of clicked, and I realized, the reason that my drums don't sound so good and the reason that I'm having trouble sometimes to get around and play with finesse is because my sticks were too heavy. I didn't have a tip. Having a tip on the stick and having a well-balanced stick is very important. So this was kind of a journey that I embarked on. It took me many years to actually find this stick. When I was in my 30s, I was playing a brand of stick called Trueline, and they were a very cool company. They turned out to be very good friends of mine. They made them custom for me, and the sticks had a kind of a ball built in so that you could kind of grip. It was like a ball inside of your hand, and I really liked those, but the sticks were very thick and there was no tip. And I used those for quite a while, even when I was playing with Yngwie Malmsteen. And then when I started playing with Tony McAlpine, we started playing more fusion-based music, and I needed to, you know, be a little bit more finesseful, have a lighter touch, and I needed some tone on that ride cymbal. You know, when you play a ride cymbal with the butt end, if you play on the bow of the cymbal, you just get a wash, you know. So I kind of wanted to get into that nice stick-defined tone that you hear on a ride cymbal. And okay, not being a jazz drummer, there was no use for that in my earlier days, my formative heavy metal days. So I was using these heavy sticks, and I started to realize, okay, these sticks have to change. Of course, when you use heavy sticks, you're breaking cymbals, you're destroying the drum heads, and when you bring the drums into the studio, the microphones, they don't hear the drums like your ear would hear the drums. They have a completely different frequency response. So you're playing hard, and the tuning was open, but it was very, how do I say, it was very dissonant, you know? It wasn't a sweet drum sound, and I was always wondering, how do these guys get that sound? So gradually, I progressed. It took me about a year. I started with thinner sticks, various pairs of sticks with a tip. And that was a big game changer. It took me a while to adjust to that as well. Then at one point, I started to use smaller drums. 8, 10, 12 were my first three rack toms, as opposed to a 14-inch tom. That also changed a lot of things. And then I went with thinner cymbals, using thinner drum heads, smaller toms, and my sound really improved, especially when I went into the studio. It was easier to tune the smaller drums, they responded better, and I could use thinner drum heads with these sticks. I could still hit pretty hard, but I wasn't destroying the drum heads. So that was a big change for me. And of course, that all came from listening to and watching my idols. Fast forward to 1997, I relocated to Europe, and I was playing with a lot of heavy metal bands and still using sticks with a tip. And I started to use the Vic Firth Maple SD4 model. I fell in love with these sticks. They were perfectly balanced. They had a beautiful barrel tip, and I realized that I could play fast, I could play with power, and still have a great tone on the cymbals and the drum heads. So I was at the Frankfurt Music Fair, walking around, and I was passing the Vic Firth booth. And I thought to myself, gee, I wonder if they would be interested in having somebody like me. So I approached one of the artist relations people there, a gentleman by the name of Marco Ciccoli, who turned out to be a great friend of mine. And he started supplying me with sticks, the SD4 model. And I was using those for many years, maybe about 5 or 6 years. And one day Marco came to me and he was like, how are the sticks working out? And I said, I love the sticks, but I'm breaking them in half. I was going through a lot of sticks, because the sticks were made of maple. Maple is a very kind of brittle wood. When you're playing with power, the SD4 was more of a jazz stick, and I was using this jazz stick to play hard rock and heavy metal. So Marco made the suggestion to me, maybe we should try to make you a signature stick. And I was like, really? That's like a dream, right? To have your own signature stick. So we started to work on this, and his suggestions to me really paid off. First and foremost being, Mike, make a signature stick, make something for yourself, but don't make something that's so weird and strange that other drummers won't want to use it. You know, make something that feels good for you, but also for other people. Of course, I took into account the balance factor, what I was deriving from the SD4. Now, the interesting thing about a drumstick is it's a very simple machine, okay? But it's probably the most important piece of equipment you will use when you play the drums. This is what puts you in touch with the instrument. And I don't know if any of you guys realize, maybe you go up and jam on somebody's drums and you grab their sticks and you start to play. Maybe they're a bit shorter, maybe they're too long. It's weird, right? I mean, it's inhibiting, you know? You don't feel good when you're playing. I feel very good when I play with my sticks. These have been in my hands for almost 15 years now, and they're part of me. So that's the beauty of having your own signature stick. The SD4 was made of maple. They were breaking in half quite readily, and of course that costs a lot of money when you're on the road and you have to keep grabbing for sticks and try to play the song and not miss any notes, so that's kind of a hindrance. But they suggested to me that we make the stick out of hickory. That really worked, because I can show you what happened. This is a stick that I've been using, I don't know, maybe about a week. You can see that. It was the snare hand. And you can see there's the tip. But I mean, it's really a durable stick. They don't break. The hickory kind of just starts to fray and wear. Eventually it would have broken, but I replaced it because the sound started to change when I was doing rim shots. Really, the stick is very, very durable. Hickory is a much more durable wood, so that solved the breakage problem. And the SD4 has the same barrel tip. I really like this. I don't know if you can see that, the barrel tip. I like this more than a teardrop shape. And also the shoulder of the stick, you can see here, it's not too thin. It's still kind of thick. So if you want to, you know, hit the bell or do rim shots on the toms, or you're hitting the crash cymbals on the edge, you're still going to have some durability and some power there. Also, my stick is a bit longer than the SD4, just a bit. And it's a bit more top heavy, which for me helps with my twirling. And also helps with the forward motion of you know, getting around the drums. Also, the stick is a bit thicker, just a bit. The SD4, again, is a jazz stick. So, I mean, I have relatively large hands. So by making the stick a bit thicker, a little bit longer to increase that kind of top-heavy throw, keeping the shoulder of the stick a bit thicker, and of course incorporating the barrel tip from the SD4 model. This is it. This is my Mike Torana signature model stick. And I'm very lucky and very fortunate to be with the company. And of course they asked me if there was any other custom things, and I wanted to paint the stick white. A lot of the other Vic Firth artists have white sticks. Jojo Meyer, fantastic drummer. Thomas Lang, brilliant. And the drummer from Rammstein, Christoph Schneider. You know, the way these sticks are made, they're not cut with a blade. They're actually pressed between two rotating stones, which cuts the profile of the stick. And that's what keeps the stick straight. You can see that. Okay. Actually, never the whole 15 years I've been with Vic Firth have I ever had a stick that was warped or bent later. And that's because when the stick gets cut with a blade, it's bound to do a little bit of a banana. There's another thing about these sticks that's kind of interesting, is that they're all weight balanced and tone balanced. There's a little machine that kind of taps the stick. I guess I'm kind of a weirdo. I will, even though the sticks are the same weight in grams, I always feel one of the sticks has a bit more density, should I say heaviness, but actually the way to describe it for me is dense. It's a little bit more dense, which makes it feel heavier. I always put the heavier stick in my left hand and the lighter stick in my right hand. I don't know why. It just feels better that way. I play better that way. So, you know, when you're playing for many years and you get dialed in on your own stuff, you start to have all kinds of little idiosyncrasies and techniques that help you play, whether or not they are really useful or really working, I don't know. But I've had some discussions with people at the factory, and they're like, both sticks are the same weight, Mike, in grams. They're the same weight. And I'm like, no, this one's lighter. It feels lighter. I can feel it. It's crazy. Anyway, one other thing I'd like to say in closing is that to be associated with the Vic Firth Company really is truly an honor, and I'm a very lucky and fortunate man. First of all, to have made a living playing the drums, and second of all, to be associated with great companies. Last but not least, I'd like to talk a little bit about Vic Firth. He was a great percussionist himself. He was a timpani player, anyone's ever had a chance to see any videos on YouTube, check it out. I played with the Boston Pops Symphony for many years. And he started making these sticks in his garage. You know, he started making mallets, actually. And when he would finish a pair of sticks, he would take a little wood burner and he'd put the logo on there, Vic Firth. That's how it started, in his garage. And it turned into this wonderful, beautiful company. And I am also like to say that I'm very honored that I got a chance to know Vic personally, hang out with him. Probably one of the coolest guys I've ever hung out with. He would tell me a lot of interesting stories. He was very open-minded. He was appreciative of every drummer and every style of music. Everyone was welcome, and he made everybody feel great. And it's just an honor and a pleasure to be associated with a company that is owned and started by a fellow drummer. They really understand what goes into making a stick. Thanks for watching. If you are interested, pick up a pair of Vic Firth sticks. I think you'll be happy and pleasantly surprised. Thank you for watching, and best wishes to all of you. Practice hard and have fun.